Hello, and welcome to Func. Today is Wednesday, April 15th, 2020. I'm Annalise.
And I'm Claudia. In today's news, Bernie Sanders dropped out of the race for the Democratic presidential nomination earlier this week. He's also made the decision to officially endorse Joe Biden, who will be running against President Donald Trump in this fall's national election.
Dr. Sleining and Dr. Liao, in connection with the Cawthorn Center, are offering 30-minute late-afternoon virtual mindfulness sessions for all Furman students. No prior experience or registration is required. These sessions will be from 4:30 to 5 o'clock Eastern Time on Wednesdays throughout April.
In Furman news, the Academic Startup Assistance Program has awarded a money grant to Furman student Trent Stubbs for his company Econobolics. This is the first time that the grant has been awarded to a private university.
Furman SGA has posted the video presentations created by those running for class-level student government positions. Primary elections take place on April 23rd and 24th.
The school has officially announced some of its plans for summer sessions 1 and 2. All summer session classes will be taught remotely, using the same online techniques which have been implemented for the remainder of this semester. No decision has been made yet regarding other summer campus activities.
Do you know what your plans are for this summer? If you haven't settled on a project or opportunity, reach out to the Malone Career Center. They are still holding weekly advising meetings for students, and it's not too late to find something to do from home or in your city.
Housing a Residence Life continues to host weekly activities for all Furman students on Thursday nights and throughout the week. Get in touch with your RA or check your hall Moodle forum for information about this week's event.
Numerous sports fans are still looking for a place to channel their attention with both the basketball and baseball seasons on hiatus. Maybe our viral video of the week will help. The video has sparked a Twitter discussion on whether or not it was a charge by the dog or a block by the kid. Funk stance? Kid's feet were moving. Definitely a blocking foul.
That's all we have for today, Paladins. Make sure to check out our website, www.can'tstopthefunk.com, to submit announcements and watch all of our previous episodes. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Instagram and Twitter, and download the Funk mobile app to keep up with everything that's happening away from Furman's campus. Have a great National Laundry Day, and tune in again on Friday for our next episode.